I want to do for you guys an impression of my face like 2 nights ago when I tried to record this song. Because for like the third or fourth fucking time, I hit the start streaming button instead of the start recording button. And it didn't even stream anywhere. It wasn't set up to do that. It just never said anything. So, you should know that that evening I was enthusiastic, and my voice wasn't all scratchy, and my playing was pretty good. I recorded for like 20, 25 minutes before I realized that anything was wrong. So, let's start over. You Are the One is probably the trickiest song to play, like, as far as dexterity goes, that I've taught you so far. It's a lot of fun, and I think if you're looking at these chords on screen and you're comfortable with them, I would say it's probably within your grasp to play this, even if you think it may not be. So, of course, the reason that I'm making it sound so harrowing is that this song quite famously is mostly about the riff, right? It's that right? Anyway, I'm going to teach you how to do that. It's going to be your job to figure out how to make it fit with your other chords. So let's just get right into it. So you're going to want to get comfortable using your first and your second fingers to do this little tiny riff. You're going to move between the B note, the A note, sorry, start there, A, open fifth string, B, open D, and then E, right? Those four notes. So, start like that. A, B, but do it as a hammer-on, so that means hit the second note without having to pluck it. You're just gonna make that noise come out with your finger. And then strum down to your fourth string. Or pick, whatever. And then you're going to kind of do the opposite. We're going to hit the second fret on the A string and then let go of it. It's a pull off. And then come over and hit that B again. It's a second fret on your fifth string. String it together and it looks like this. Now the reason that I'm saying you're going to want to get comfortable with this with your middle finger as well, is that it goes in a couple different directions out of that little riff to various chords, and some of them it's much more comfortable to make if you're already using your middle finger at the second fret somewhere, rather than, because I mean, your hand is definitely doing two very different things depending on which of these fingers you're using to hold the same note, right? And so naturally it lends itself to making different chord shapes more or less easily depending on what you're doing with your hand. So I'll explain that as I go along. If you look at this opening here, I've got us doing the riff to an E minor to a D, then the riff to a G to an A minor. That is most of the song. So check this out. Right, that's your first line. And then you're gonna pluck it out again. Thank you. I'm doing is, when I'm coming out of an A minor, I am using my middle finger, because it's already right there, right? It's just one string over. If I'm making an A minor, I'm just going to use my middle finger and inch it over and use it because it's already lined up. Meanwhile, if we're going to a G, then we're ending this riff with our pointer finger, doing the whole riff with our pointer finger, but ending on the second fret, same note, the B note, that is shared with the G, right? So it's easier to use your pointer going to G, and it's easier to use your middle finger going out of A minor to the riff, right? So it's kind of like a tongue twister for your fingers, but you will get used to it. That's the verse, every single last one of them, and so that takes us to, well, sort of. I guess not exactly. The verses are choppy, and then you'll drop in the riff where you see fit. So check this out. So we'll go. Now I won't surrender at any cost. It's something so sweet and tender from my heart. Yes, I've done my So, it's the same exact chords in the same exact order. And you see here that I've also got this little B note optional thing. That is, if you listen to the song, they'll sometimes hit, is that B? Yeah, B. They'll sometimes hit what's meaningfully, for our purposes here, a B note in between these chords. So, what I tend to do, because that's a lot, is I don't specifically aim and target and hit that B note every time. I usually just kind of swipe across the low strings, but it's in there, right? So but anyway, so if you want to be very specific and hit that targeted B, go for it. On to the chorus, though, we do a C to A minor, over to E minor, and then D, over and over and over again, and then the last time we just don't go to E minor and D, right? So we have three, I could have typed this out better, but we have three variations that are, or lines, I should say, that are all the same variation, and then the fourth variation, or the fourth line is different from the first three because it's just C to A minor. I'll show you what that looks like. So A minor, E minor, D, C, A minor. You can do a riff here if you want to. Just go C, A minor, and then we go back to the verse. The only other little tip I would give you is that the song actually starts a little higher. And then it kind of slams down into these low notes. It actually, you can start it up here on the 7th fret. And what you've basically got to do is use your pointer finger on two strings, right? So that we can do our hammer on and then come right over. We're on the 4th string, and then we go right over to the 3rd, so. It's the same idea. And then E minor, still. It's just like this, but it's higher. D. And you can make a D however you want. You can either slide it down like that to the 5th fret with an A shape, or you can come up here and do a E major shape on the 10th fret. I think it might sound a little better, but it's all up, you know, it's whatever you want to do. So E minor, so let's do the riff. You have to come back up for this. And then we go down to G, up to A minor. That's how we start the song, right? I only figured that out about 10 minutes ago, so, you know. I'll try it in the demo for you guys, but. Oof, here we go. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, and. Something so sweet and tender from So, like I said, it's not... It's very intimidating.
Oh, what is that?
It's very intimidating, but it's not that hard. Like, it's not unattainable if you feel like... if you feel like you can do all of these chords, very basic open chords, and you're willing to put some time into it, you can do this. And especially if you're not like comfortable with a pick, or if you prefer finger picking, this is great for that. Right? So anyway, go out there and knock them dead. And if you like what I'm doing, you can like this video. And why don't you leave me a comment or something and subscribe to my channel. Because we got a lot more of these to do. And I am having a good time. And I love all of the positivity in the comments. Except for like one guy who said, "You talk too much, so I'm downvoting you." Like, it's a tutorial. I don't know what you want. Anyway, so take care. Be safe. Bye.